Oke, halo semuanya. Saya akan mencoba untuk membahas mengenai creative writing meeting 11 dan writing 12 yang berkaitan dengan bagaimana cara menulis puisi atau how to write poems ya. How to start a poem? Try one or all of these poetry writing exercise. Kalian coba ya. Salah satu sebentar. Ya. Kalian coba ya salah satu dari ini. Look at an old photo. Lihatlah sebuah foto tua. Write about everything not in the picture. Feel free to move and from reality. Describe a place you have never been to. Be as realistic as possible. The catch, it has to be a single word list. Jadi menggambarkan sesuatu kan yang belum pernah ke sana, misalnya ke Paris. Coba coba gambarkan. What is the last dream you remember using color and smell? Ya, mimpi kalian seperti apa? Gunakan mungkin warna atau mungkin apa? Aromanya seperti apa? Finishing the sentence and continue the story. When my heart hits the pillow, ya mungkin bisa dengan melanjutkan kalimat. In 13 words, describe your oasis. Ya, kalian coba melakukan itu. Okay, starting a poem. Bagaimana sih cara menulis sebuah puisi? Yang pertama, brainstorm for idea. Try a free write. Grab a notebook or your computer and just start writing about your day, your feeling, how you don't know what to write about. Let your mind wander for 5 until 10 minutes and see what you can come up with. Ya, bebas saja. Bebas menulis apapun, termasuk kalau kalian nggak tahu apa yang mau ditulis, tulis aja. Write a prompt, look up a poem prompts online and comes up with your own, like what water feels like or how it feels to get bad news. Write down whatever comes to your mind and see where it takes. Make a list or mind map or image. Yeah, think about a situation that's full of emotion for you and write down a list of images or idea you associate with. You could also write about something you see right in front of you, or take a walk and note down things you see. Jadi sebetulnya menulis puisi dengan menulis cerpen itu hampir sama. Jadi kalian bisa menggunakan perasaan-perasaan, bisa menggambarkan suasana-suasana yang kalian lihat di sekeliling. Kalian bisa saja misalnya pergi naik bis, di dalam bis itu ada pengamen yang sedang menyanyi. Nah, kalian bisa merasakan satu perasaan-perasaan yang bisa kalian tulis menjadi sebuah puisi ya. Starting the poems, get inspired by your environment and those close to you. Inspiration for a great poem is all around you, even if you don't see it. Think of every memory, situation, and moment as possible topic and you will start seeing food. Ya, sebetulnya apapun yang ada di sekitar kita bisa menjadi puisi. Bahkan ketika kita merasa bosan di rumah, itu juga bisa menjadi puisi. Bagaimana misalnya kita merasa bahwa benda-benda di sekeliling kita, seperti sapu, seperti pel-pelan, seperti horden, mereka seperti tidak pernah berhenti bergerak dan membuat segala sesuatunya menjadi berantakan. Ya, itu juga sebetulnya bisa dijadikan sebuah puisi. Finding a topic, go for a walk, head to your favorite park or spot in the city, or just take a walk through your neighborhood. Use the people you see and nature and building you pass as inspiration for poems. Yeah. Write about someone you care. Think about someone who is really important to you, like a parent or your best friend. Recall a special moment you share with them and use it to form a poem that show that you care. Misalnya, ingat tentang ayah, misalnya ayah apa yang dilakukan ketika kecil. Oh, ayah saya waktu kecil sering menggendong saya untuk melihat bulan purnama. Nah, itu juga bisa dijadikan sebuah puisi. Pick a memory you have strong feeling about. Close your eyes. Clear your head and see what memories come to your forefront of your mind. Pay attention to what emotion they brings up to you, positive or negative, and probe into those strong emotional moments make for beautiful and string poems ya. Bisa juga ya apa saja ya perasaan-perasaan yang kalian rasakan satu ketika kalian tiba-tiba merasa begitu takut dan pada saat itu mungkin ada keringat dingin yang bercucuran dan sebagainya, itu bisa dijadikan sebuah puisi. Nah, ini salah satu brainstorm yang bisa kalian lakukan, apakah temanya romance, atau friendship, atau family, atau grandma, atau broken heart, atau nature, atau winter night, atau funny story, dan seterusnya. Pick a specific, you can start by focusing on specific theme, ya. Apakah kalian mau milih tema tertentu, apakah puisi politik, apakah puisi romance, apakah puisi tentang alam, atau puisi apa. For example, you may decide to write a poem around the theme of love and friendship. You may then think about a specific moment in your life where you experience love and friendship, as well as how you would characterize love and friendship based on your relationship. Read example of poetry. To get a better sense of what other poets are writing, you may look through examples of poetry. You may read poems written in the same poetic form you are interested in, or poems about themes or idea that you find inspiring. You may also choose poems that are well known and consider classic to get a better. Nah, salah satu yang apa yang kita lakukan di pertemuan sebelumnya, membaca puisi dari Sapardi Djoko Damono. Nah, seperti itu. Kalau baca puisi-puisi yang lain, kita jadi terinspirasi, oh cara nulisnya begini ya ternyata. Starting the poem using concrete imaginary. Avoid abstract imaginary and go for concrete description of people, places, and things in your poems. You should always try to describe something using the five senses: smell, taste, touch, sight, and sound. Ini sebetulnya apa ya? Tips ini juga sebetulnya bisa berlaku di dalam cerpen. Jadi kalian gunakan panca indera kalian untuk untuk menggambarkan apa yang mau kalian deskripsikan. Tentu saja bedanya adalah puisi lebih pendek ya, puisi lebih pendek dan lebih kuat ya. Using concrete imagery will immerse your reader in the world of your poems and make image come alive for them. For example, rather than try to describe a feeling or image with abstract words, use concrete word instead. Rather than write "I felt happy," you may use concrete word to create a concrete image. My smile lit up the room like wildfire. Nah, kalian bisa gunakan kata kalimat-kalimat yang kuat yang menggambarkan suatu bayangan yang nyata. Include literary device. Literary device like metaphor and simile add variety and depth to your poetry. Using this device can make your poem stand out to your reader and allow you to paint a detailed picture for your reader. Try to use literary device throughout your poems, varying them so you do not use only metaphors or only similes. Gunakan literary device. Mana saja sih literary device? Kita lihat berikut ini. Nah, contohnya, kalau metaphor, I was a bird on a wire. Similarly, my heart is like an empty stage. Ya. Jadi, ini semua masuk literary device. Nah, ini jenis-jenisnya. Ada metaphor, simile, personification, atau alliteration. Metaphor, this device compare one thing to another in a surprising way. A metaphor is a great way to add unique imagery and create an interesting tone. Example, I was a bird on a wire, trying not to look down. Jadi ada membandingkan diri kita dengan sesuatu yang lain. Kita membayangkan diri kita seekor burung, ya. Kalau simile, compare to thing using like or as. They may seem interchangeable with metaphor, but both create a different flow and rhythm you can play with. She was as alone as a crow in a field. Ya, dia sesepi. Apa? Sesepi seekor gagak ya. Jadi benar-benar dibandingkan dengan langsung ya, dengan like atau as. My heart is like an empty stage. Ya. Hati saya seperti ruang pertunjukan yang kosong. Personification, if you personify an object or idea, you are describing it by using human quality or attributes. This can clear up abstract idea or image that are hard to visualize. The wind breath in the night. Jadi benda-benda mati diberikan karakter seperti manusia, angin bernafas gitu ya. Alliteration occur when you use word in quick succession that begin with the same letter. This is a great tool if you want to play the way your poem sounds. Jadi ada kesamaan-kesamaan suara walaupun tidak sama persisnya, seperti Lucy let her luck linger. Lucy dan luck itu kan terdengar hampir sama ya. Terus ada juga linger juga dari L ya.